Hey Canucks fans, and welcome to Clay's Canucks Commentary for Tuesday, December the 19th. Tonight, the always popular Montreal Canadiens come into town to face the Canucks at Rogers Arena. Expect a crazy and fun atmosphere, just like it was 2 weeks ago when the Toronto Maple Leafs came into town. In that game, the Canucks won 2-1 in a very exciting game, and let's hope that the Canucks can have a similar performance and result tonight. If they do, one player that we'll have in the lineup and will likely contribute to that will be defenseman Eric Gudbranson. He's returning to the lineup from injury. And to make way for him, it's not Derek Pouliot, it's not Alex Biega, it's Ben Hutton being scratched for the first time in his professional career. So we'll see what happens. Travis Green talked about it. He wanted to keep that righty-lefty balance, so that means you're not going to take Tanev out, obviously. So that means it's either going to be either Hutton or Biega or even Pouliot going forward. But tonight it's Hutton, Gudbranson's in, and we'll see what happens. The Canucks called up Reed Boucher from the Utica Comets. He's having a great season there. And that's because they are unsure if Brock Boeser will play. Now, the mood has completely changed. I know when I recorded my blog on Sunday night, the sky was falling. We were worried, is Brock's foot broken? Is it bruised? Is it a sprain? What is it? Well, it turns out it wasn't broken, thank God. And he's either really tough or it's not as bad as they thought, because he was actually skating and skating hard at practice. It's going to be a game-time decision. We hope that he does play. My gut feeling is that he won't, just because they didn't say right away that he would, unless they want to do this massive surprise and this big reveal and that he is playing. But I'm guessing he's going to at least miss one or two games just to make sure he is fully healed. There's really, really no... Of course, we want to see him play, but there might not be a massive rush to get in the lineup, especially at the risk of further injury. But we'll see. If he does not play, expect Reed Boucher to come in his place. And today I want to talk about Jake Virtanen. Many of you viewers may know that I write occasionally for Daily Hive Vancouver, as one of their Canucks writers. And today I wrote a piece on Jake Virtanen, and I want to echo a few of those thoughts right here, right now. And I'll also include a link to that blog down below. Jake Virtanen's time to shine is right now. With the slew of injuries that the Canucks are facing, especially to forwards like Horvat, Dorsett, and Sutter, Baertschi, and maybe even Boeser for a little bit, Jake Virtanen has a perfect opportunity to rise up and to get and continue to get more ice time. His underlying numbers, Jake Virtanen, despite his poor ice time numbers, and I'll get to that in a sec, his underlying stat numbers are really good. His Corsi, or basically his percentage of shot attempts that the Canucks take as opposed to the opposition, he's one of only four Canucks that are over 50%. You have Henrik Daniel at over 54%, which makes sense. Then you have actually Jake Virtanen at 50.6%, and then Derek Pouliot right behind him at 50.5%. Only four Canucks have a positive Corsi. Everyone else is negative. And you have other bottom six forwards like Dorsett and Sutter and Gaunce and Chaput and Dowd that are in the 30 and 40% numbers. So that's one good thing about Virtanen, is that when he's on the ice, the Canucks tend to outshoot their opponents. And obviously, the more you shoot, generally, the more you score. An interesting thing about Jake's ice time, I mentioned that it's been all over the place. He's had as low as 8 minutes. He's had as high as 14 minutes this season. And even that 8 minutes was just two games ago in San Jose. And then he had 13 minutes the next game against Calgary. So even from game to game, he's had a swing of 5 minutes. And a lot of it has to do with special teams. Jake does not get to play on special teams. On power play, he's had a total of 3 minutes of power play time this entire season. Contrast that to the Canadiens, who have over 100 minutes each. And on the penalty kill, it's even worse. Virtanen has actually 10 seconds of penalty killing time, which is the lowest on the team, including forwards and defensemen. So obviously, he hasn't earned Travis Green's trust that way, to be on either the power play and mostly the penalty kill. Will that change going forward? I think it will, as soon as Virtanen continues to develop his game. And his game is a good game. He's fast. He's strong. He's got an excellent release. And his hockey sense is improving as he plays more and more. But the much maligned forward, as I said in the blog, in the past 3 years, a lot of people compare him to other guys that were drafted in that draft class after him. That's maybe an unfair comparison, because different guys develop at different paces. And in the 3 years since he's been drafted, he's had 95 games in the NHL, 67 games in Utica. He hasn't really lit up the lamp in either place right now, but he is developing into a steady bottom six forward. I know some of us want to see even more from him. Lastly, he can fill roles that a lot of other guys have vacated with their injuries. Bo Horvat has a good tendency of driving to the net and creating havoc for defensemen and goalies. Jake Virtanen is starting to do that more, of getting to the net. Sometimes he gets whacked in the face by the opposing goalie stick, but hey, at least he's getting to the net and creating opportunities that way. He's got maybe the second best release on the team behind Brock Boeser. Jake Virtanen has got a wicked wrist shot. I'd love to see him use it more, especially getting into the slot where he scores most of his goals and really let that shot go. And he can agitate other teams like Derek Dorsett can. Or Derek Dorsett did. And we saw that a little bit in the last game against Calgary. Virtanen took 3 minor penalties. None of them were bad penalties. They're all because he was agitating Calgary or standing up for his teammate. So he can fill in offensively. Like he can shoot like Boeser, maybe not as good. He can rush the net like Horvat. And he can certainly agitate teams like Dorsett. Those are 3 things that he can do that's going to earn him even more minutes in the Canucks lineup. Okay, you can tell I'm a Jake Virtanen fan. This is a Jake Virtanen shirt. I really want him to see him do well. And that can start tonight, whether or not Besser's in the lineup or not. Virtanen's got to really start to take advantage of this opportunity with all these other forwards out. He's a lock to stay on the team for the rest of the season. So let's see if he can indeed earn Travis Green's trust, get more ice time, maybe some power play, some penalty kill time, probably power play time before penalty kill, and become a vital part of this team going forward. Love to hear your thoughts. Do you think Jake Virtanen will indeed blossom into the player we want him to be? Do you think he's basically maxed out and what we see is what we get? And what are your other hopes for the team with or without Brock Boeser? Hopefully with. All right, enjoy the game tonight. Go Canucks, go. God bless, and have a great day.